Charlie, swordofsurvival.com with another survival training episode for you. Today I'm going to show you how to make survival shoes out of the yucca plant. I actually had a request for this on my post, and I told the gentleman that sent the request that I would learn all I can to see if I can make anything like that. Couldn't find anything on the internet, so I just had to play around with what I had out here. And I came up with something that would actually work. So the plant I'm talking about, let me show you. Type of plant I'm using is the narrow leaf yucca bush, because the broad leaf is just a little bit too wide. And I'm also using as my jig the stalk from the yucca plant. I'll show you this here in a minute, what I mean by jig. Also, with this, you're going to need some type of cordage. If you don't have cordage, it's right there. On one of my other posts, I show you how to make cordage out of the yucca leaves. Okay, like I said, here's the items you're going to need right here. You're going to need probably, but for each shoe, you're going to need about, as long as you can get them, the thin leaf, narrow leaf yucca leaves. You're going to need about 30 or 40 of them per shoe. You're going to need two sticks about a foot long, and of course your cordage. This cordage right here, I braided out of and twisted out of the those strands there for my cordage. Okay, now to prepare to make the jig, like I say, you need a foot long about there, a stick. I use the yucca stick, and you split it part way down the middle, but not all the way, because you're going to be sticking your yucca leaves in between there to hold them, just like I've done here. Okay, this is going to be one end. What you're going to do is you're going to stick as many yucca leaves in here as wide as your foot you're going to be using, and you're going to allow for about a half inch on each side past your foot. This one's I'm only going to do a partial one, because I got one made over already over here that I'm going to show you, but this is going to be a quick demonstration on the braiding or the weaving technique when I do this. So these are how they're set in here, and you want about 3 inches leaves extending from each end. So basically going to take the other end, open up your jig, and the other leaves are going to go in there like that, and make sure that they're all lined up, and you're going to crimp them down, and you're going to tie your other Tie the string on there and there, and kind of hold them down like a clothespin. And the length from here to here is going to be an inch longer than your foot. So let me go ahead and finish tying these off, get the jig ready, and I'll show you the weaving technique. So basically, you're going to have rows like this that you can take the longer leaf, and you'll cut them in half, make them shorter. These are ones that are going to go sideways. They'll go in, under and over, under and over, and over, just like you're weaving a basket. Just like one of those cotton looms where you make blankets and stuff, the way the thread and everything goes over and under, it's basically the same pattern. What you're going to be doing is making something that's going to look like this, like a size of foot flat, like a mat. You're going to be making two of these per foot. And the reason I suggest two is because, one, you got more protection from the ground, and two, when you tie your string on and loops on here, that's going to hold it to your feet. Those strings will be able to adhere to the top surface of the top mat, and instead of rubbing on the ground as you're walking and cutting your strings and your shoe comes off. That's why I suggest that. Unless you have some really good strong string, then one layer is fine. You know, if you got some old shoe strings or something like that, a paracord. But I'm making everything strictly out of the yucca leaf itself and the yucca bush and the stalks, okay? So that's why I suggest making two if you're gonna use that. Okay, so the basic technique is, let me put the rest of these on the ground. You take one leaf and you just hold the jig flat in your lap. You're gonna go over and under, skipping in between each one of these leaves right here. This is gonna be boring to watch, so I'm gonna make it quick. I'll pause on the camera now and then, but that's what it looked like when you get your first. Hope this is coming out pretty good. I got the sun in my eyes. Once you get your first one in there, then you're gonna take and push it all the way down as close to the base of your jig as possible. This is gonna be your heel of your foot. What you can do, you can take an old stick or something later on as you get two or three in there. What I do is I get about five in there at a time, then I start locking them in. I'll show you what I mean by locking them in, but you can take this and hold it and use that to push it down. You want the weaves as tight and close together as possible. Now these plants here, they aren't exactly flat. They're kind of half oval shaped, and I usually pound them with a rock to make them a little bit more pliable. So let me go ahead and stop the film here, put a few more sideways rows in there, and then I'll show you how to lock them in. Okay, I'm back. I put about four sideways rows in there widthwise. I haven't made them really tight yet, because once I start to lock them in, I can push them down a little bit further and make them tight, but I kind of left them spaced apart for video purposes. What I mean by locking in is that as the sides are sticking out, you're always going to bend these over the top of something else in order to lock them in. That means this leaf is resting on the top of this first one, so that one's going to be bent over there that way. This leaf is underneath this one, so it's going to be bent backwards this way. Okay, that's the basic idea. Now, when you bend them over, you're going to do a backwards weave, which means you're just going to go under and over in the opposite direction, like this, until you get them all the way across. You have to manipulate them a little bit. They get really tight. And then once you do that and you pull, it locks it in. Okay? And that same leaf, as it comes back the opposite way, you go underneath the next one, back in on itself. And it locks it in. Man, I hope this is coming out on a video. I can't really tell. But you got weave once away, and once you turn it around, the end ones get weaved backwards on itself. And that's what locks everything in. And then once you get the first four or five locked in, then you push them down back towards the heel, making them tight, which will make them come out looking like this. Okay, now that's the jig and the original preparation setup. Now that we'll go ahead and go To the next step, let me pause and get everything else together and I'll show you. Okay, I'm back. Okay, like I said, again, it's going to require two in my design, two completed foot length platforms and a handful of long, narrow leaf yuccas. And basically what I'm going to do, this one's a little bit narrower than the other one, which is okay. I did it kind of quick. You're going to decide which one you want on top, the part that's going to sit on your foot. I notice here some of these are kind of sticking out, so I'll look on the other side. And these are a lot better. So basically all I'm going to do is figure out which one I want on top and bottom and set it right there. Okay, next thing I'm going to do is you're going to make some cordage. You're going to need three of these about a foot long, because what you're going to do with these, they're going to be circled on each other, and these are going to be the loops that your string is going to go to, which will tie to your feet. And what you're going to do is loop this through your top, figure out where your toe is going to go, and then loop this in with three, at least three loops, and then tie it off in a knot. Your toe will sit here, and then you're going to use another one about where your ankle bone sits on the right side of your foot and where your ankle bone sits on the left side of your foot. So you're going to have a loop coming up this way, loop on the right, and loop on the left. Let me go ahead and put those loops in for you, come back and show you the next step. Okay, I'm back. Here's what I mean by putting your smaller loops in. I got one up here where my toe is going to go between. Well, this actually, toes will go in between there. I have a loop on the right side near the ankle, loop on the left side near the ankle, and I got it going across at least two vertical strands of the leaves there to make them strong. Now what you're going to do with this, in order to protect these from getting cut from the ground, like I said, is that you're going to put this on top of the base like that. And that will protect these loops from getting chewed up by the ground that you're walking on. Now once you get these situated to where you want them on top, the next thing you're going to do is you're going to weave, just like you did the cross stitch, the cross pattern going across here, is that you're going to connect these two together by weaving in and out like you did when you made the actual platforms going crossway. You're going to put about maybe one every 2, maybe 2.5 inches across until you get them top, and then once, you know, of course, lock them in like you did to make them so they won't come apart. Once I do that, I'll go ahead and do that, stop the camera, because it's going to be boring to watch me do it, and I'll come back and show you the finished part of this.